Hi, in this video we are going to see about average value program in swing application using Java. Here we create a project in NetBeans. So in this I already created a JFarm class name as a average. So inside this I am going to give the designing page code. So inside this I am going to first of all declare a label. Equal to new label so here next I am going to declare a text field So next I am going to declare a button. Add equal to so next I am going to declare a scroll panel so J list and equal to new pen open close bracket semicolon. So next I am going to declare a list. So next default list model. Value list model equal to new and say this so next I am going to declare a clear button equal to clear button equal to new the button. So next I am going to declare a average text field designing code. Average text field equal to so in this I am going to give new J text field so next time I am going to declare a compute button so compute equal to new button. I want to use J button. So next in this I am going to declare a variable int
into the private int I. So next I am going to inside the main method, I'm going to build the form. So I'm going to use this code for build form. So new class name as average, that show so next I'm going to use the method public inside this public average. So inside this I'm going to set the title name as average value. So set title, inside the double quotes I'm going to give average value. So I'm going to set the size, so set resizable. Inside this I'm going to declare a boolean value true. So next I'm going to add window listener, window list inside the bracket new window adapter. So inside this I'm going to declare a method window closing action. So public void window closing. Inside this window event E. So inside this declare exit form in the bracket E. So inside this I want to close this, where I am going to create a method. So it will create it. So next inside this I am going to give the position control, and I am going to give the enter the code for the background and font color and set text also. So in this get content pen, so dot in this I am going to call the method set layout. Inside this I'm going to give the new grid layout. So next I'm going to declare grid bag construction. So grid constraints. Equal to new constraint. So here I am going to enter the enable enter label. So this I'm going to call the setText method. Inside this I'm going to give the string value as I enter the number. So next in this I'm going to set the x-axis and y-axis. Here dot grid x, this I am going to give the value 0, and dot y axis value as a 0. So next get and dot add, inside this enter label comma with constraint. So next time I'm going to enter this text field, enter field dot the text, inside this I'm going to give nothing in the double quote. So next I'm going to set the column size, enter dot set column, so this I'm going to give the value 15, the column size. So inside this grid constraints equal to new grid bag, grid bag, get. So once again I am going to give the x-axis value. So here grid constraints dot x, I'm going to give the value 0, and that y axis I'm going to give the value 1. So next this I'm going to insert equal to new insert within this 0 comma, then and once again 0 comma 10. So inside this next get content dot say this dot add, say this enter text field comma grid constraints, so inside this enter the text field dot add action is, so inside this I'm going to give new action listener, so inside this I'm going to give the action perform. So in this public void action performed, the bracket action event. Here I'm going to enter that. Enter text field action performed. Say this E. The semicolon. Say this. I'm going to close the bracket. Here I'm going to create a method. Next I am going to set the text to add button, so add button dot set text. Inside this I am going to give the name as a add to list as a button name. Next I am going to give the grid constants equal to new back constants. This is the bracket, nothing. So here I am going to give dot x axis grid x dot equal to 0 and dot y equal to 2. Next I am going to insert dot insert equal to new stretch zero. So next I am going to get add button. So in this I'm going to give the add button action listener. Here add button dot add action listener. Inside this new action listener inside this I'm going to declare action perform method. So public void action perform. Inside this I'm going to give action event e. Inside this I'm going to give add button action perform this. Inside this E. This I want to close the bracket. I am going to create a method. So next I am going to declare a set model. So value set list first. List dot set model. Let's set this value list model. Let's list plan. List and dot inside this new inside this I'm going to set the dimension size 150 comma 150. This time dot set u port u. Inside this I am going to give the value list. So next, this I am going to give the grid constraints equal to new grid bag. In this I'm going to set the x axis equal to 0, the y axis equal to 3. If I'm going to insert this I'm going to use 10, 10, 10. So next get add say this list comma grid constraints so next I'm going to set the text for the clear button so clear clear button dot the text inside this I'm going to give the button name as a clear list in this I'm going to set the size for the button so grid constant equal to this once again I'm going to just copy and paste this. This I am going to give the name size as a y-axis 4. So next get content and dot add inside this I am going to give clear button this content so next clear button dot add action seller inside this I am going to give new action seller So inside this I'm going to give the method action performed for this player button. So in this public void, so this action performed, inside this action event that is, so in this player button, inside this I'm going to give E. So here I'm going to close. Sorry, I'm going to create a method for this. So next I'm going to set the text for the text field. Then this I'm going to set average text field. The text inside this I'm going to give nothing. Inside this dot I'm going to set the column. Set column inside this width as 15. Next I'm going to set the editable size. So dot set editable, this I'm going to give a boolean value false. So next I'm going to declare a background color. So set background color, if I'm going to declare the color as a white. So next I'm going to set the alignment, set horizontal alignment, set this in constant, constant dot center as alignment. So inside this I'm going to declare some, so this I'm not using. Copy. This I'm going to do this. In this I'm going to give the value 5. In this 0. Next, in this we want to put average text field. So next compute button, I'm going to set the text for the compute button. So compute come button dot, so text inside this I'm going to set the compute button as the compute average. So this I'm going to once again set. So here I am going to declare as a y-axis tick. In this I am going to declare inside this I am going to give compute button. This compute button dot add action listener, inside this new action listener inside this I'm going to give the method action performed for public void action performed. Inside this action create compute button so this E this I'm going to close that bracket. Here I'm going to create a method. Inside this compute action listener. So compute button dot action new action listener. Import this. Select. Here I am going to give stack group so next time I am going to give the method enter text field action performed so in this I am going to give private void enter text field action performed inside the bracket action event e with this so here add button dot do click so next here next time I'm going to declare as a private add button action so private void add button action performed action event inside this I'm going to check the valid number or not. So in this I'm going to use if statement. So if in the bracket not valid decimal validate decimal number inside the bracket. Enter text field and return create method select. In this I am going to add the value list control for value list model so value list model dot add element method inside this I am going to give enter text field so here I am going to copy I'll put this. So this dot get text just enter values enter text field dot set text inside the double quotes and going to nothing view next dot request focus method I'm going to call. So next time I'm going to give the action button and I'm going to create a method for this. Next here I'm going to create a method for a clear button action. So private void clear button action performed inside this action event. So here I am going to reset from the another average. So here I am going to give value list model dot remove all element method I am going to call. So next average text dot set inside the double quote I am going to nothing give. So next I am going to set the average text field average dot capital F dot set text inside the double quotes I am going to give nothing. So next enter text field dot request focus method so next time I am going to declare a method as a compute button for action performed so here I am going to give private void compute button action performed so inside this action event inside this I am going to give the int count equal to value list model dot get size. So make sure number have been entered. Then this I am going to give if statement. So if in the bracket count not equal to 0, then this double my value is equal to inside this count double my average So in this, I'm going to give my value. Inside this I equal to double dot value of inside this value list model. Model dot get element at I connect method to string dot double value my value. This obviously want to put cap. So next with my average. My average equal to average. Say this count comma my values in this. Create a method for this. It will avoid this error. So we are next. My average. After this, average product dot text. Inside this new decimal format in the bracket double cost 0.00 and that format inside this object my average . So next I am going to enter the text, enter text field dot request focus method and then okay. Create a method. So in this next I'm going to give the method exit form for so private void exit form inside the bracket window even each inside this I'm going to use system dot exit with as a 0 . So next I'm going to give public double average number value comma double field . So here next I'm going to find the average, so I'm going to give in decimal double data type for and sum equal to 0,0. Next inside this I'm going to give for statement, for statement in Java instead of like int I equal to 0. I equal to 0 and I less than number value comma I plus plus, that means increment. Inside this sum less or equal to value inside this value. It returns sum slash number value here. I'm going to declare a valid decimal number method, so public boolean, so validate decimal number. So this text field yes change this to check if the state test contains valid decimal with only digit and single decimal point. So here I am going to declare string yes equal to cf dot get text dot string. So boolean as decimal equal to boolean value is declared as a false. So in this boolean valid, the boolean true. Next if statement, in this if test dot length double equal to 0, so this valid equal to false and this helps equal to for single bracket int I equal to 0 and I less than or equal to yes dot length I plus plus inside this char c equal to s dot caret method, this index I, so inside this I'm going to give if statement. So if this c greater than equal to single quote 0 and c less than or equal to inside this 9. Or in the bracket c double equal to and I double equal to 0 continue. So next else if in the bracket c double equal to and not decimal. So in this half decimal equal to true. So next inside this cell valid false valid equal to false next I'm going to give invalid character found. It means if inside the bracket valid if tf the text here else inside this df dot the text within double quotes I'm going to give nothing df dot request focus this is return valid so next time I'm going to execute this. So now I am going to run this program. So it's running. Finally it will execute. In this I am going to enter some value and I am going to add to the list. So once again. Again again. So here I am going to compute the average value. It will bring the decimal value 7.67. So this is the simple compute average value program in Swing application using Java. So thanks for watching this video.